The purpose of this video is to present how to use search and refactoring type actions in Oxygen's JSON schema design mode. For this demonstration, I have three sample schema files that are designed to validate JSON files that contain information about books from a library. I'll start by opening the lib-item schema file. I'll right-click and choose Expand All to expand the diagram. This sample schema considers the book ID, the publishing house, and the book description. Then I'll open the borrowed-book schema file, expand it, and this one considers a book reference code and the publisher. And I'll open the lib-book schema file, expand it, and it considers the title, genre, and authors. Now, when writing JSON schemas, it is considered a good practice to use the definitions section to group subschemas with descriptive names that can be referenced where needed using the ref keyword. Definitions and references are good for avoiding duplication and allow users to write schemas that are easier to read and maintain. It's also a common practice for related schemas to share definitions, referencing them through the ref keyword. So I will show you that Oxygen includes some actions in the design mode's contextual menu that could prove useful for working with such constructs. For example, suppose I want to see all the occurrences of a particular definition. I'll right-click this medium length string definition. I'll go to the search submenu and I'll select search occurrences in file. All occurrences of components within the diagram that use the medium length string name are listed in the bottom results pane. And if I click on each one, you can see that it highlights the particular occurrence inside the document. I'll right-click the same definition again and go back to the search submenu, and this time I'll select search references. This action searches for all references of the selected definition in a scope determined by the schemas referenced in the file and the schemas declared in associated validation scenarios. Again, I'll click on the occurrences and notice that the third one switched focus to the publishing house property from another file, the lib-item schema file. So this definition is shared between the two schema files. In regard to the scope of the search action, it searches the current schema file, then it searches other schema files that are referenced in the current file, and then it searches schema files that are declared in associated validation scenarios. In my case, the second criterion is the one responsible for including the lib-item schema in the scope of the action. Indeed, you can see that the ID property in the lib-books file contains a reference to the ID definition from the lib-items file. As I mentioned earlier, the two schemas share some of the definition constructs. Now, it may not be able to detect all references of a certain definition since the scope is strictly defined by the criteria I mentioned a minute ago. But to broaden the search scope, I can use the search references in action. It is also found in the search submenu. The resulting dialog box allows you to provide a custom scope for the search operation. I'll select the working sets option. I'll click New Working Set. I'll name it lib-scope and press Enter. And I'll click Add Resources. I'll choose Folders. And it automatically chose the correct path to my lib folder, so I'll click Choose. Then I'll click Search, and again the results are listed in the bottom pane. Compared to the previous search, an additional result was found this time. It's the first one listed. And clicking it highlights the publisher property from the borrowed/books file. And you see that it references the medium length string definition from that other lib-books file. So we found that the particular definition is used in all three schemas in my working directory. The final action I want to show you is probably the most useful of them. In the process of designing schemas, sometimes you may want to change the name of already created definitions. However, those definitions could be referenced through their names by various other components, either from the source schema file or from other schema files, as we saw in the previous example. So a rename operation is needed that would detect all references to the respective definition within a specified scope and modify the names of the definition accordingly in all components that reference that definition. I'll right-click the same definition again, and this time I'll select Rename Component In. And in the resulting dialog box for the new name, I'll add Type in capital letters at the end of the name. Notice that the Rename and Preview buttons become available, while the Working Sets option is selected along with the lib-scope working set I created earlier. Now I want to propagate the name change to all files from my lib folder, and for this demonstration, the scope described by the lib-scope coincides with the scope provided by choosing the Project option. I can preview the proposed changes, and I can click on each file to see the specific modifications to be done on that particular file. And clicking the Rename button accepts all the proposed changes and completes the operation. You can see that my three files have an asterisk in the Editor tab denoting that there are unsaved modifications. In this file, notice that the medium length string definition has been changed, and the reference for the title property has been changed, and the reference for the name property has been changed. I'll save this file and go to the next one. Notice that the reference for the publishing house property has been changed in this file. And in the borrowed-books file, notice that the reference for the publisher property has been changed. One final remark, the schemas I've been using in this demonstration are version draft 07. If you're using one of the latest versions, the 2019-09 or 2020-12 drafts, then the defs keyword is used instead of definitions, but all the actions that I showed you in this demonstration work the same on the newer schemas as well. That concludes the demonstration about the search and refactoring actions that are available when working with JSON schemas in Oxygen's design mode. As always, thank you for watching, and we invite you to please subscribe to our various social media channels.